My name is Jordan Barnes and I am a first year trainee. We come in at 8 o'clock and then we're ready to work at our benches at 8 o'clock, get here a little bit earlier. We will be given a job by our mentor. He will go through the job with us and explain what we have to do, and then we'll get all of our tools out, get the materials that we need, and then once we have all of those, we'll obviously do the job. I feel like my relationship with my tutor is very professional. So, you know, if I do encounter a problem, I can go and ask him questions, or if I've done something wrong, then he doesn't jump on your back about it. But at the same time, I also feel like we can sort of act like friends. I chose engineering as a career because I always felt like from an early age, I was a lot more hands-on and learned a lot better by actually doing something rather than sitting down reading a book. And then when I was in school, I always performed better in the technical subjects like resistant materials and product design. And then from there, I studied engineering in college, and then sort of it all just fell into place. There are many advantages of doing this apprenticeship because we are developing lots of hands-on skills here. I'm in the workshop most days of the week, and then when I'm not, I'm writing about what I've done. So I feel like I'm gaining a lot of skills in that respect. You do have to be successful in year one, but at the same time, that doesn't mean that you can't make mistakes, because in the first year, we're here to learn and develop our skills. But at the same time, I also have to present myself as a person to all of the bosses and the mentors. And, you know, if we do make an error, then we go through and talk to it. But I have to give it my all in my first year. I would recommend the Silverson apprenticeship scheme to a friend, because I feel like for me it's made me gain lots of skills that I wouldn't find anywhere else, and also develop personal skills. It's grown me as a person, so that would definitely be a good option for someone else. Usually we finish work at 4:30, but we will pack up 5 minutes earlier so we can put our tools away and take all of our uniform off. And then I can reflect on the day. Usually I come away with many positives. I've developed a lot of skills, and you know, I can continue to bring that forward into the next day.